Are you ready to jump into a world of swords, magic, and the power of the stars? Throne and Liberty is a new MMORPG that sees you taking control of a Starborn. After surviving a raid on your hometown as a child, you take control of your character years later as war arrives in your homeland of Silesium.
To help you harness the power of your star fragment and fight back against the armies of Khazar, we've prepared this list of things you need to know when starting a new character in Throne and Liberty.
Presented by Throne and Liberty.
It's your weapons that'll save your life in battle.
When you're just starting out, you'll be given the option to choose between a combination of 7 different weapon types. These types are the greatsword, sword and shield, daggers, longbow, crossbows, staff, and wand. Each of these weapons has access to unique skills, attack ranges, defense options, and skill specializations, so try each type to see what you prefer most. You can also pair different weapon types to get the benefits of one weapon while using the skills of another mid-fight. Throne and Liberty has a fresh take on exploration and traversal. Players can morph into creatures that can glide through the air, swim in the sea, or sprint on land. When morphing, players are able to move more quickly, which can be used to adjust positioning in battle or arrive at your destination faster. Gliding and swimming morphs also allow you to explore Silesium's more hard-to-reach locations or even enter combat against your enemies from above. Each time you level up in Throne and Liberty, you'll be given a single stat point to allocate to one of 4 stats: Strength, Dexterity, Wisdom, and Perception. Adding points to any of these stats will increase your weapon damage no matter what you're wielding. Different weapons gain stronger advantages depending on which stat is leveled up. For example, Greatsword scales most strongly with Strength, while Staff scales better with Wisdom. Level up your character in line with your weapon loadout to make the most of your potential damage. And don't worry, stats can always be reset, allowing you to test many combinations during your journey. The world of Silesium is full of things for you to do, including numerous different world events that take place at different times during the day. An early quest you will receive will point you in the direction of one of these events, the Wolf Hunting Contest. This contest takes place over a 20-minute time period once every few hours, and sees you competing with other Starborn to collect the most wolf tails. You can check the game schedule from the map menu to see what events are taking place at which times. While taking part in activities like the wolf hunting contest, pay attention to NPCs for hints on how to complete these tasks more effectively.
Make sure that you help each other whenever possible.
Once the contest starts and you begin collecting wolf tails, you'll find NPCs struggling to fend off wolves in the wild. And if you help them, they'll drop their own collection of wolf tails for you to collect.
Please accept this in return.
This is a much faster way of collecting wolf tails, and could see you winning the competition if you help more adventurers than the other Starborn who compete alongside you. This isn't shown to you with an explicit tutorial, so watch out for small details like these when participating in other events to see if you can get a leg up over the competition.
Welcome.
During Chapter 3, you'll unlock the ability to take on contracts. These are side missions that usually see you defeating monsters and collecting resources within a given area for a reward of upgrade components and crafting materials. You can hold up to 5 contracts at once, and these contracts are great to collect when you're exploring new areas or doing other side missions at the same time, as you can collect more rewards for exploring areas you already needed to be in. Be sure to regularly check in with the local contract manager to keep the rewards flowing.
Here are today's contracts.
Another upside of completing contracts is you frequently receive training dew, which can be consumed to increase your weapon mastery. Weapon mastery allows you to choose additional bonuses for your currently wielded weapon. Unlike other bonuses in the game, only the mastery trait of your currently wielded weapon is applied, so change strategically between weapons depending on your enemies. After you've completed a few chapters of the main story, you'll start to find Stellarite. This is a consumable item that you can attach to one or both of your weapons, and while your Stellarite is active, you'll receive a flat damage bonus on all of your attacks with that weapon. Each attack consumes some Stellarite, and you tend to find them in groups of 1 or 200 to start out with. You'll quickly deplete your supply if you equip your Stellarite immediately, so we suggest that you hold your Stellarite and use it when you come up against a difficult encounter or boss fight. That way, you'll be saving this bonus effect for when you need it most. During the opening of the game, you'll be introduced to a friend called an Amatoi, who will help you as you explore Silesium. You can unlock various cosmetics for your Amatoi, and they'll even help you in battle by automatically healing you with World Tree leaves once your health drops below a certain threshold. With this in mind, be sure you have a healthy supply of World Tree leaves at all times. You can buy more of these from Sundry's merchants. You can also change the point at which your Amatoi starts to heal you in the settings menu. When you've reached level 15, you will unlock Skill Specialization. After each level, you will receive skill specialization points you can distribute to add powerful changes and upgrades to your base set of skills, sometimes even changing the skill entirely. These upgrades allow for deep customization of your weapon's abilities and let you customize loadouts for different encounters and situations. Do you want to focus on single target damage? Maybe you want to have more healing at your disposal. The power is in your hands. That was just scratching the surface of all there is to do within the game, but you'll have to discover the rest for yourself when Throne and Liberty releases on October 1st for free on PlayStation 5, Xbox Series consoles, and PC. For more on all things Throne and Liberty, stick with IGN.